Right, hello everybody. We should be live. Let me know if we have sound real quick before we get going. I'll pull it up on my phone here and check. Let's see. Gotta head over to the register, make sure we get the music changed. Sound, yes, says Fox Leader. Excellent. Hey Joe, can you come change the music? Excellent. What's that?
Is it 3 o'clock?
It is 3 o'clock.
My gladiator music.
We got Lemur Bricks, who I heard it's their birthday today. Happy birthday, Lemur Bricks. We got Ethan, what a bum, doesn't work here anymore. We've got Dan Smith, we got Fox Leader, we got T Valkyrie, we got Grumpy J, and we've got, oh, nope, that's just the StreamYard message. Anyway, we are here today for our Friday store tour. It's our only store tour of the week nowadays, and we will be going for 30 minutes, so make sure to get any requests in for things you would like to see today here at Atlanta Brick Co. We'll be walking around touring the world's largest selection of Lego and helping all you wonderful people find the Lego that you're looking for. Dust off the bricks. Hey, how you doing? Good to see ya. Let's see. Anybody else? Ethan says the store looks different. Yeah, you should come in once in a while. You might see some more things that you don't recognize. Although maybe you will be coming in soon. I saw your dad submitted a trade-in form with some really nice sets, so maybe you'll have an excuse to come in. Hey, Geology Joe, how you doing? Let's see, Lemur Bricks wants to know, how much is the Lego House Pirate from the thumbnail? I didn't even think about it when I was taking it, but yeah, I bet you can see the pirate in the background of the thumbnail. Let's go find out. I believe it's $350, but it is a very nice set. I was fortunate enough to get one myself. Let's take a look. This is the Lego House exclusive, a minifigure tribute based on the classic Captain Redbeard. And it is $350, but a very nice set. Some nice graphics on the back showing off a lot of different old minifigures, even some early prototype minifigures there. Very cool. As well as some of the other Lego House exclusive sets. Very nice. Very nice set. Highly recommend. Any of those upscaled minifigures are cool. I hope they do more of them. All right, let's see. Daniel Griggs, can you tell me the price of the Lego typewriter? Let's see if I can find it. Did you see one somewhere recently, Daniel? Geology Joe says, "Arg, I'm not sure if he's doing his pirate impression or if he's frustrated because he really wants to buy the pirate." Let's see. Also, Daniel, are you talking about a sealed-in-box Lego typewriter or a built one? Let's see, Fox Leader says, so there's large base plates that mounted on plywood. Does that come in solid green or light bluish gray? Ooh, good question. I don't know if we still actually have any of those for sale. I know the ones that you're talking about. We had some for a while. We use them for tank battles, usually. So I don't remember the last time we actually had them out for sale, but I bet there are probably some in light bluish gray. Raymond says, hello from Amarillo, Texas. How you doing, Raymond? Lemur Brick says, I'm getting the regular upscale minifig today. That's nice. I actually still have not gotten that one. I need to pick that one up. Geology Joe says both. Both is pirate impression and frustration at not being able to, or at how expensive that set is. Over by the city sets on the wall. All right, let's go take a look. Over by city sets on the wall. Typewriter, Joe, have you seen the typewriter? He said over by city sets on the wall. I assume he means city section. Over by the city sets on the wall. Let's see. This is where our city section is, or did you mean creator sets, maybe? Let me take a look. I'm pretty sure we have one. I just haven't seen it recently.
Bill?
How about over here? I've not heard. Was that, Daniel Griggs, was that built or in the box?
I think I remember seeing a built one. I don't know about a sealed one.
I feel like this is the kind of stuff where it might be.
Is it here or up front now?
Let me go look up front one more time. Turn around, he says. All right, give me something more specific than that, because I'm not sure exactly when you sent that chat in relation to where I was standing. But I would assume it would be close over here, but I'm not seeing one. Not seeing one. We got Queer Eye, we got the Adidas Superstar, we got Friends, Sonic, Tranquil Garden, Floral. Not yet. Right there. He said it was right there where the DeLorean is. Okay, so we might have sold it then.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can always check on our website to see if we still have one.
Let's do 10 to sell.
Geology Joe, I assume is singing song lyrics, but I'm not sure what it's to the tune of. Lemur Bricks, I have seen the flower pots. I really like the look of those. They're very nice. I think the name of the set is kind of strange. I think it was just like tiny plants or something. But strange. Ethan, there are some turbo tanks kicking around, actually. We sold one recently, as is, but I think I saw another one. Where did it go? It might be buried in here. But yeah, I think there is one that we were working on inventorying. Well, wait, it was the one that we got the box lid for, but now I don't see that either. So maybe it is out. I don't know. From an old hip-hop song, says Geology Joe. Oh yeah, sure thing, Daniel Griggs. Happy to take a look for you. But yeah, definitely search it up on our website, too, if you want to get the most up-to-date information. It's possible we have one either in another condition, or you can also sign up there to get notified if we get one put back in stock. That's the fastest way to know if we get one. All right, I'm just going to keep looking around. Feel free to drop any other requests down in the chat or in the comments. Definitely hit that like button if you want to support our channel. I think, even though we switched to half an hour, I think it's still 50 likes if you want to see me put on the Nexo armor. So do that, or maybe I'll talk about minions or something. Ugh. Geology Joe says, Daniel's good at reading the comments as they come in. I do my best. Fortunately, they're going a little slower so far, so I'm able to keep up with it. Do we have a built Mighty Bowser? I'm almost certain we do, Lemur Bricks. Let's take a look and see if I can find a Mighty Bowser for you. He should be pretty hard to miss. He's very large and yellow. Let's see. I'll keep doing a lap looking for Bowser while I read some more comments. Let's see. Lego Yard Man says, hello, hello. Welcome in, Lego Yard Man. We're just doing a tour of Atlanta Brick Co. here. Walking around, showing off everything we've got, and answering any requests for any Lego items of any kind that people are looking for, sets, minifigures, custom kits, you name it. If there's anything Lego you're looking for, feel free to drop it in the chat, and I will do my best to see if we have it. Let's see. Man, I know we had built Mighty Bowsers. I would be hard to believe that they're actually all gone. Did they buy it? It's all gone? There was one in the Star Wars section for a long time, but then we rearranged it, so maybe that one sold because we moved it. Don't see one up there. That one's another kind of grab bag area. Yeah, there was one back in this corner of what used to be the non-Lego section, but I think we moved it all out. So I'm going to say we maybe don't have one. But again, check on our website because it's possible we have one maybe pre-owned as is if you're looking for a good deal. Or otherwise, I do know we have them sealed, in sealed condition. Yes, Geology Joe, coming at us again with the song lyrics. Peaches, 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 peaches. Lego Yardman says, love the new store layout. I do too. I really like the way it kind of flows now. I especially love that we've been able to group a lot of things that were previously kind of scattered all around. So we've got this really nice polybag wall here with all these great polybags all grouped together. And then all of our custom kits are now in one place. So you've got a nice place to look at all of our custom kits. Here's a great new item. We finally have Mark and Steven custom minifigures. So you could get both of them. We also may be soon doing a sort of three-pack. We might take a bunch of the Build-A-Figure packs that we get, you know, from trade-ins and everything else. We might use those three packs and design a new custom backer card to do Mark and Steven and not Ed. We would do Mark and Steven and have like a trophy in the middle spot. So we got to see if we can buy some cool trophy pieces or maybe design a little one. Yeah, sorry, no, it's not welcome in the three pack. It's the Lego Master three pack. Yeah, maybe. No, I think we'll do Mark and Steven and like a little trophy in the middle would be cool. All right, let's see. But yes, I do love the new store layout for sure, Lego Yard Man. Geology Joe says, any new noteworthy non-production parts? I don't think so. We tend to get them in kind of in batches, but not very frequently. So I can take a little look-see here, but I don't think there's anything particularly new that's noteworthy. But as far as ones that I like, I'm always a sucker for any of the transparent ones. So these nice transparent orange, blue, red parts. These transparent yellow 1x6s were a little bit newer, so maybe it depends on the last time you were in. Let's see, 2x3 trans yellow bricks. Let's see what else is out. A lot of light nougat parts, a lot of yellowish green parts for some reason. And then these are not necessarily non-production parts, but actually we're getting a bunch of new old stock light gray, old light gray parts, which is pretty cool. And then up there in the corner, those are not Lego, but somebody in Japan was making these Lego bricks out of wood. Those are kind of fun. Those are neat. I got just one of them. Pretty cool, pretty cool. Geology Joe says, it's really nice, the store layout. Yeah, for sure, for sure. The stairs are the best thing, which I don't know if Mark ever gave an update, but we are now all up to code with full-length handrails on both sides. We've got some nice caution tape up there on the overhead so Mark doesn't hit his head. Although he still, every time he goes down the stairs, he'll bash his hand on like the air vent to make it make a loud noise so that somebody thinks he hit his head on it. It's a great, great dad joke.
So funny.
Geology Joe says that would be cool. Use the Triwizard trophy. Yeah, we could do that. We could do that. There's a nice molded one that comes in, I think, metallic gold. Not the little small one that comes in pearl gold, but like the big one that's like almost as tall as the minifigures, which would not be that far out of scale with the real trophy, honestly. I mean, it's a big trophy. So we'll see what we can do with that. All right, Raymond says, wondering where your masonry bulk bricks are. I don't think we've ever had masonry bricks in bulk. We barely get enough of them to do commission builds and things. I don't think we sell those in bulk. Yeah. Geology Joe says, I'm into all those rare ones. Yeah, for sure. Bought the Transred 2x6 a while back. Yes. Pretty much any non-production parts that we get here in the store, I buy at least one of each to do to add to my display of non-production parts. I've even recently been buying a few non-production parts for various mocks and things when I need to. All right, let's see. Any good condition Republic gunships non-UCS? Let's go take a look, Ethan. Any Modulex? Modulex is one of the few things that I think I have almost never seen the entire time that I've worked here. It's very, it can be very hard to come by. However, there is a lady who always goes to Brickworld Chicago, who she even does like workshops on Modulex, where she'll give out little goodie bags to all the participants in the workshop. And then usually at the yard sale at Brickworld Chicago, she will also sell Modulex parts. So I bought a bunch of Modulex at Chicago this year. So yeah, if you ever go to Brickworld Chicago, you can get the hookup from that lady. She's very nice lady. Let's see, not seeing any gunships there. Ethan, is there a specific one you were looking for other than non-UCS? Looking for anything built, anything in the box. Bow, bow, bow. Not seeing too much. Corey Philbrick says, do you have any giant pirates made out of bricks for sale? Yeah, we already showed it off, Corey. Show up to the stream on time. Nah, Corey's a good friend of mine. We can go show it off again. I think he just wants to look at it, even though I know he already has one because we went to Germany together and we did not get to Lego House. We were at Lego House like about a week before they revealed the new pirate set. But then after we got back, I was able to get someone to send us some from Denmark. So I know he already has one, but we'll go take a look at it anyway. Wasn't able to find any Republic gunships for Ethan, though. Let's see where to go. There it is. We'll go through kind of all of these sets on the top shelf because there's some really cool ones here for sure. We've had this Imperial Star Destroyer here for a minute, but the Ghostbusters Firehouse just came in. I don't know. What day was that? That was within the last week, right, Joe? Before the store tour? Oh, that's all right. We'll go through them anyway. Ghostbusters Firehouse, fantastic set. That one is sealed brand new.
Wait, did you say the Firehouse or the Star Destroyer?
The Firehouse.
The Firehouse we got on the Monday haul.
Okay. So I don't know if there was a Monday haul video, but anyway, there's a bunch of great new sets here.
The Monday haul we went to get.
Yeah, I'm saying I don't know if Mark did a video about him. Probably not.
He hasn't been in since.
Well, there you go. Then that's probably new. So that one's going for, looks like $1,000 for that one, sealed brand new. That'd be a good one to get in time for Halloween. We've got the Mountain Cave, certified pre-owned. We've got the Disney Castle. That is the older version, but I believe, didn't we also get the newer version? Do we still have it? Right behind me. There it is. We're going to spin around. Hopefully not too fast. Hopefully you don't get sick. There's the newer version of the Disney Castle as well, sealed. And then going over here, certified pre-owned, we got the London Bridge, or Tower Bridge is the actual name of it. We've got a sealed Quickie Mart. Very hard to find one there. Let's see what that one's going for. Looks like $600 for a sealed Quickie Mart. We've got the Ecto-1 to go with your firehouse. And then over here, Joe was sort of curating a modern interpretations of classic Lego themes here. We got the Galaxy Explorer. We've got the Barracuda Bay. And I think we had a 90th anniversary castle here and maybe some of the Forestman gift with purchases. We had like all of the remake sets. Eldorado, yeah, we had an Eldorado Fortress over here, but it's been a little picked over now. Still some great sets. There's the old Y-Wing there. $600 on that one, certified pre-owned. There's a really nice ExoForce set, sealed brand new, up on the top shelf there. Let's see, that one is only $300 brand new for an ExoForce set. That seems like a pretty good deal. Let's see, Lego Yardman said Tower Bridge. I'm not sure if he was saying because I said London Bridge first or if you want a price on it, but it is $300 certified pre-owned on the Tower Bridge. Geology Joe said plan on going to Brick World Chicago next year. There you go. If you sign up as an exhibitor and you are able to register for workshops, I would highly recommend signing up for the Modulex workshop. It's very, very interesting. Here's some other good stuff. This is one of favorite sets of mine. Speaking of remakes of classic sets, there's a nice little group of four there. You got Barracuda Bay, Galaxy Explorer, the Yellow Castle, and the Airport Shuttle Monorail. Let's see, we also got the Back to the Future DeLorean here, certified pre-owned for $120, not bad. A Flintstones house, that one looks to be new sealed for $120. The Ideas Ecto-1 looks to be sealed for $170. Yeah. We've got the Big Bang Theory, certified for $220. We've got Steamboat Willie from Lego Ideas. Ooh, here's some more Aqua Raiders. Oh, what's this? What's this? 50 years on track. This is a great set, and I say that not even having built it yet. I own this one, but I have not gotten a good excuse to build it. Where's the price tag on this one?
It's on the top with the barcode.
That's right. This is that strange one where the barcode's on top. $300 for that one. Sealed brand new. That is
so cool,
really cool. So again, getting, you know, remakes of classic sets, I always love to see that, and Microscale is another thing I love. So look, you got the Metroliner, you've got the Futuron Monorail, you got the Emerald Knight here. These are some great trains from Lego history, remade in sort of a new, unique scale. We got another ExoForce set here. I guess Mark's been out for a while. These wouldn't be here that long if Mark was in this week. He would have taken all of them. We've got a ton of classic castle and pirate sets. A lot of these are actually sealed brand new. We came into a bunch of those recently. There's that classic ninja, Flying Ninja Fortress, sitting up there on top. That one is sealed, calling my name, but I'm going to resist the urge.
You just got to gloss over the Mystery Mansion?
Yeah. Look at that, Mystery Mansion up top. You got Velma right front and center. She's, how much does she go for on her own? Like 160?
160 or 170.
180? Yeah, I don't know. Crazy. But yep, there you go. There's the Mystery Mansion up there. That one's sealed new.
I think it's only $400.
Yeah, I can't see the tag on that one. Right behind Captain Rex Spark Speeder set. Fantastic. Got a Jango Fett Slave 1 tucked away back there, certified pre-owned. A V-19 and an ARC 170 right next to each other. Look at that. And then we've got a Cloud City right here. Look at that. Pre-owned as is with instructions, but without minifigures or animals. So you can get the build for the set, Cloud City, in good condition with the instructions. For $600, that looks fantastic.
You just missed Palpatine's Arrest as well.
Okay, you want to just go through every single set in the store?
Palpatine's Arrest.
That's is a good amazing one. That's a good one. Certified pre-owned still goes for $500. That's insane.
Yeah.
That's insane. Lego Yard Man wants to look at some Chima sets. Sure, we can do that. Geology Joe, I agree. I think Mystery Machine would be the next logical large-scale creator vehicle.
Sick.
I think that makes the most sense. Do it in the size of like the VW camper van. Maybe that's why they're not doing it, is because they've done two VW vans at this point. I don't know. Let's go take a look at Chima for Lego Yard Man. Anybody else who's just joining, we're doing a tour of Atlanta Brick Co., one of the world's largest Lego stores. So there's anything you're looking for that's Lego related, feel free to drop it in the chat, and we will see if we have it here, because we have a lot of things. So let's take a look at some Chima. It's looking a little picked over right now, actually. Don't have a ton of Chima. We got Tiger's Mobile Command. That's actually pretty cool, and that's a lot of orange parts in that. Let's see, Sir Fangar's Sabertooth Walker. I like the sort of ice wave of Chima. That had like a lot of the saber-tooth tigers and woolly mammoth looking type stuff. That giant woolly mammoth robot build is a really cool one. I think they did that on the Joy of Building one time. Got some smaller ones, Rascal's Glider, Lion Tribe Pack. Got a ton of Chima gear, as well as speeders sets, poly bags. Here's a number of certified sets here. We'll look through these too. I may not get the names on them since it's just the instructions. I've not studied up on my Chima set names. There's some good ones there. That's got one of those big... Yeah, there's the big woolly mammoth guy. Yeah, nice. Sparatus's Spider Stalker. That's crazy looking. All right, let's see if there's any other Chima sets hanging around. Looks like a lot of the gear and books and things down there, but not a ton of sets right now. It's actually sort of being taken over by Minecraft. Even Nexonites is slowly dwindling away. I'm sure Mark is laughing all the way to the bank. If you want to see me put on the Nexo armor, feel free to hit that like button. We will get it'll take 50 likes if you want to see me get that Nexo armor. We're already at 22 minutes, so you have 8 minutes left on the store tour. I have no idea how many likes we're at right now. Maybe Joe can tell me. Yeah, you're very welcome, Lego Yard Man. Happy to help out. Chima is like modern Fabulans. Not for long, Geology Joe. That is going to be rapidly taken over by Lego Animal Crossing as the modern Fabuland. 15 likes. So sad. So sad. It's probably because I didn't do a special thumbnail like Mark does. He's much better at thumbnail creating than I am. Let's see what else is new around here. We've got some nice stuff in the castle case. Got a classic Eldorado Fortress. Got some Western sets. Let's see. We recently got all of the Fantasy Era Trolls put online. So there's all the different variants of those, including the ones from the Trolls Mountain Fortress, which I know they built recently on the Joy of Building. Let's see what else is cool down here. Oh, I know this was new. We got an Orient Expedition set here. Sealed brand new. It's wrapped in shrink wrap for some reason. Maybe just because the box is sort of caved in. But it's the Elephant Caravan set for $180 if you want to get that one brand new. That classic gray elephant is exclusive to this set. They also did a light gray one in a different set. I think the Scorpion Palace. But that one is exclusive to this set. A very cool set. Very nostalgic for a lot of people who had some Orient Expedition sets growing up. Got some other great adventures sets as well from the jungle theme. You've got the River Expedition there, as well as the classic Sphinx Secret Surprise. That one's certified. Very nice, very nice. From Pirates 3, we were recently talking about this when we did... Actually, maybe the video hasn't come out yet, but we did a video all about sets from 2009. So I think we talked about this one in there. I think this one should be 2009. Let's take a look. Let's see if I'm right. It's hard to look at the bottom of the box with one hand. Oh, bear with me. Where's the year? Yep, 2009. I was right. Pirates 3 was 2009. The last year, this is what was interesting about 2009, was 2009 was the last year that LEGO produced a full wave theme for a castle theme, a pirates theme, and a space theme, which is really interesting. So since 2009, they have been sort of scattered to the wind, the three classic themes. Bum, bum, bum. Yep. Animal Crossing, exactly. That's the new Fabuland for sure. All right, let's see what else we got. We got the Indiana Jones original temple hiding back there. Krennic Shuttle, the Home One set. That's one that's very slept on. That one was also from 2009. Yeah, I know I talked about that video in the 2009 video that we did recently. Maybe that's the one that's coming out this weekend if it hasn't already. All right, let's keep taking a look around. There's our fantasy football trophy. I don't know if we know who won that yet this year, if it's still going on. Oh, okay. Still going on. Shows how much I know about fantasy football. There's a nice gunship there, but I know Ethan wanted the non-UCS one. Got a couple Palace Cinemas up there on the top shelf. Hang on, let's pan around. Look at that. Geology Joe wants to know what the priciest poly bag is that we sell there. Oh, it's got to be one with a minifig in it. Let's go take a look. Ben Sutherland also says, time to bring him back, the big three. I agree. It seems like there's some rumors going around that space maybe making a comeback next year. But I totally agree. I think they need to get back to their roots a little bit and not rely on licensing so much. All right, let's see. Most expensive poly bags. The first one that comes to mind would be like Silver Centurion, if we have one of him. I know he's, what does he go for now, Joe? 70 or 80 bucks? A Silver Centurion? Iron Man?
He's about 120.
Is he really? He's way more. The question was the most expensive poly bag that we have. So I said it's probably one with a mini thing.
A random one we have with a mini thing. The most expensive one I think we've ever sold, either Darth Revan or the Shadow Arc.
Yeah, Darth Revan or Shadow Arf would make sense for the most expensive we've ever had. As far as currently have, I'm not too sure. This, you know, stuff like this Captain America one might go up to as much as like $30. I don't know if you count this as a poly bag, but that's the exclusive black VIP card, Star Wars VIP card that comes with that minifigure. And that one is $500. It isn't a Ziploc bag, so maybe not technically a poly bag. But, yeah, I don't know. Not anything super crazy right now. Oh, here's a pretty good one. Okay, there's $70 for the Star Wars Boost mini droids sort of poly bag there. That's getting up there. All right. Yeah, Ben's other one says Revan. Yeah, we don't have one right now. Joe was just going for most expensive we've maybe ever had. Let's take a look. T Valkyrie says, bring back at least 1 hour tour a week. We're going to try this for a little longer. Mark is able to get a lot more done with his week when we limit this back. So we're looking to do a little more short form content as well. Yeah, you're very welcome, Geology Joe. That's kind of one of those interesting tidbits that it's cool to look up. Let's see. We got a Home Alone house over here. That's going to be gone pretty shortly, I imagine, once we tick over into November. A lot of our Christmas sets will start going out. But if you're still looking for something for Halloween, we've got a Stranger Things house set up there. That one is $290, but that's 20% off. All these built sets are going to be 20% off. As you also probably saw in the thumbnail, we've got the Hocus Pocus set. That one would not be 20% off, but that one is pretty hard to find right now. So you get that one for retail price here. For the Hocus Pocus. Lego Yardman says, any Jackstone? I doubt it, Lego Yardman. We've probably got some Jackstone figures or maybe sets in our graveyard or in our as-is stuff downstairs, but we rarely ever get anything sealed or even anything that we bother to inventory. We got some interesting stuff over here. There's the Pirates chess set. And then up on the top shelf is another employee exclusive set. So the 50 Years on Track we looked at earlier was a employee exclusive, but the Borkum Riffgrund is the windmill, the ship that goes out and sets up the wind farms, the offshore wind farms. That was another employee exclusive set from, at least 7 or 8 years ago. Yes, correct, T-Valkyrie. $230 is the retail on the Hocus Pocus set. Yeah, Geology Joe, if you want a Stranger Things house, we've got that built one. I don't think we have any in the box right now, but that you get a pretty good deal on that built for sure with 20% off. All right, we are at about 29 and a half minutes. If anybody has any last minute requests, I will do my best to find them in the time we have left. Take a look at Bricky Bobby. Say hi to Bricky Bobby here. And otherwise, we will begin rounding out the stream. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit that like button. It really helps out the channel. Also, you can feel free to subscribe if you're not already. Ooh, let's see. Robert Angel from Facebook says, vertical supports that are in the case. Yeah, we can go look at some supports. I believe, let's see, were they in? Nope, this one was all castle parts. I think supports should be in one of these ones up front. Yeah, T-Valkyrie, absolutely. Randy was kind enough to share her Hocus Pocus building experience on the Joy of Building. over the last 2 weeks. So definitely go check those out if you missed them. And here are some of our supports. So we've got, these are all online. So every different part type and part color. You've got black, white, old dark gray, dark bluish gray, reddish brown, dark blue. So some nice, those classic support type pieces. But if you go on our website, you could either search supports, or if you go under the relatively new parts tab, there should be a category for supports. So you can peruse those all at your leisure on our website now. Alex is doing a fantastic job adding all of these to our website. Any part you see here with a barcode underneath it means that it is on our website, which is getting to be almost all of these ones in this case now, which is fantastic. It's been long overdue that we get those available for sale in places besides just our storefront. All right. Thank you all for joining. Yeah, Geology just said it's like a candy store. Exactly. Exactly. It's definitely evocative of that, the way they're all in those nice little trays, all the bright little colorful parts. So thank you all for joining today. I'm sure we'll have a Between the Studs episode coming out over the weekend. Otherwise, we will probably see you next week with all of our regular schedule starting over again next week. So have a great weekend, everybody, and we'll see you later. Hit that like button on the way out. Oops, hit the hocus pocus picture. See you, everybody.